Today, we're going to talk about vases. I made a short, fat vase in the length below. I'm going to make one a little taller, a little thinner, a little more flair. I don't usually make a lot of vases. If I do make a vase, I generally put a face on her. I don't know if this one will get a face or not. I'm not sure how far down the vase flair path we can go because I don't make a lot of vases. So let's just see. So this is centered. I'm going to open it. How I open everything. Just push it down, pull my middle finger to the palm of my left hand. Now in throwing a vase, I'm going to keep this top in. It's a lot easier to keep it in than to put it back in if it gets out of control. So I've got some height to this. I'm going to go down and make the vase's tummy. And I'm going to leave the flare up here for later. I'm going to go down and clean up the water on the inside of that. And I want to make it a little bit bigger on the bottom so the flare looks a little bit more contrast, whatever the word could be. Okay, so then I'm going to cuddle this in, squeeze it in, and pull it up and see if I can't get a neck on my bottle. My fingers are now just working straight across from each other. If I want to push out, they dance out. If they want to push in, but the pressures are directly across from each other. I'm going to 6-point cuddling that up a little bit taller. Pull it out into some flare. There we go, looks like a genie bottle. A little skinnier, a little more flare. Let's see, as I said, let's see how far down the flare path we can go. Make it a little bit skinnier in here. A little bit fatter there. Give the top a little bit of definition. There we go. Cut off the outside. I got quite a bit of clay there I can get rid of. See, I don't want to push on the outside now because I can't get in there and support it here. And if I do a lot of pressure here, it's going to fall down there. And if I were going to go along the rib or something, you'd have to be under here to hold it up. So, I think our lovely little vase is about done. Let's see. Put some lines on it. When I was a girl, 147 years ago, I made a vase that looked much like this, and I thought it was really cool. Now, 147 years later, I'm not all that impressed. Anyway, if you like watching me make my vase that is not that impressive, you can hit the like button. If you want to see me make stuff that's a little more impressive, you can subscribe. If you have any comments, I'd love to hear your opinion of my lovely vase. Leave them in the comments below. And thanks ever so much for watching.